Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied about what is Gibbs free energy change and how does it related with the spontaneous or a non-spontaneous of a particular reaction. So now we are going to study about what is the relationship between standard Gibbs free energy change and equilibrium constant. So let us talk about it. So friends, now we are going to talk about the relationship between standard Gibbs free energy change and equilibrium constant. So before understanding what is the relation between that, we should also know that what is actually standard Gibbs free energy change. So let us talk about it. So here we have standard Gibbs free energy change that has been denoted by delta G naught. While delta G is just for the Gibbs free energy change, while delta G naught is for standard Gibbs free energy change, where all the reactants and all the products are present in a standard state. So let us talk about it. It says that the free energy change for a process at 298 Kelvin and 1 atmospheric pressure, in which the reactants are in the standard states, are converted into the products which are also in the standard states. So the thing is, the 298 Kelvin and 1 atmosphere pressure are the condition where the standard states are being obtained for the reactants as well as for the product. So in this condition, if we measure the change in Gibbs free energy, then that would be the standard Gibbs free energy change. So this is denoted by delta G, as I have mentioned earlier. So now we have to relate this thing with, that is the standard Gibbs free energy change, with the equilibrium constant. So for that we have a reaction. So this is a reaction where A moles of A plus B moles of B is an irreversible process with C moles of C plus D moles of D. And as you know that the forward reaction, the reverse reaction, that means it is a reversible process, and in reversible process the equilibrium constant can be obtained, just as in law of mass action that we have did in our 11th standard. So now in this case, the delta G, that is the Gibbs free energy change, is related to the composition of reaction mixture and the delta G naught. Means the delta G has a relation with the composition of the reaction mixture as well as with delta G naught, that is nothing known as standard Gibbs free energy change, in a relation as delta G is equals to delta G naught, that is the standard Gibbs free energy change, plus RT, that is where R is equals to gas constant, T is the temperature at which the reaction is being proceeded, and natural log of Q, where this Q is nothing but the reaction quotient. So if the species are gases, this concentration are expressed in partial pressure and the reaction quotient will be represented by Qp. While if the species are in a solution format, and the reaction quotient will be now represented as Qc, and this concentration will be nothing but the molar concentration. So in this case, the Qc is the main thing that is telling about the composition of the reaction. That means what will be the quantity of product, what will be the quantity of the reaction throughout the whole process, or at equilibrium. That detail is given by the reaction quotient. So for that we have, because we have two conditions, that is when the species are present in gases, or when the reactants or the products, if the both are been present in the gaseous state, then this reaction quotient will be represented by Qp. And if the reaction is for the liquid, or for an aqueous solution, or as we could say, so in that case the reaction quotient will be now Qc, and the concentration is now for a aqueous solution is usually measured in molar concentrations. So therefore this Qc will represent the molar concentration of the reactant as well as for the product. So how can we write this thing? So if we have, suppose a reaction, as I have mentioned earlier, like A of A plus B moles of B, that will react to form C moles of C plus D moles of D. And in this case, if I have to derive, or if I have to represent the reaction quotient for the pressure, that means when the reactants and the products have been present, or they have been mentioned in the partial pressure of the reactant as well as for the pressure, then in that case I could represent it as Qp. So now in this case, as we could see that it is always the ratio of the concentration of the product divided by the concentration of the reactant. So in this case, because the partial vapor pressure or the partial pressure is just for the gas that we have, so therefore in case of the reaction quotient at pressure that we measure. So therefore, it in that case it would be C moles of, that is, I could write this as pressure of C, that is this product C raised to C, into the partial pressure of D raised to D, while that of, when it comes about the reactant, now it would be that is partial pressure of A raised to A into partial pressure of B raised to B. So this is for the reaction quotient when it is been, when the pressure has are been represented for the reactant as well as for the product. And what if happens if the solution or if the reaction is been undergone in an aqueous solution, or if the reactants and the products, they are both forming a solution, then in that case it would be represented as QC. And in this case it would be very much simple to represent the concentration of product and the concentration of reactant. In this case, as we could see that the concentration is that the concentration of C is, I could represent as in square bracket, so concentration of C raised to the number of moles that we have, or we could say as stoichiometry, into D, that is the concentration of D, molar concentration of D raised to D, the whole divided by concentration of the reactants, or in that case we could say it as molar concentration of A raised to A into, that is multiplied by molar concentration of B raised to B. So this is how we represent QC and QP. So now suppose these values are basically not at equilibrium actually. So these are the values that are other than, or rather than, when the solution or when the reaction is in equilibrium. So this these values are not at equilibrium. So for what, if we have the solution or if we have the reaction when it is possessing an equilibrium process, so in that case now the QC or the QP that we have, so now that will be at equilibrium. The reaction quotient will be nothing but K, where K is equals to equilibrium constant. Where K is equals to equilibrium constant. And we have also did a lecture on the Gibbs free energy, that is, in that we have got to know that at equilibrium the delta G or the Gibbs free energy change is found to be zero. So therefore in that case delta G will be zero. So what we will get, so since we know the formula, that is delta G is equals to delta G naught plus RT natural log of K, because in this case we will write K. We could also have written as Q, but the thing is we are representing it in equilibrium when the reaction is in equilibrium, so therefore we will write it, we will represent it by K. But the delta G is being represented as zero at equilibrium, so therefore it would be zero, and the thing is this will be delta G naught plus RT natural log of K, and this could be written as Gibbs free energy change, that is the standard Gibbs free energy change, which is equals to minus RT natural log of K. But this is not done yet. We could represent this equation in another format also, that would be delta G naught is equals to minus 2.303 RT log to the base 10 of K, and in this case K is nothing but the equilibrium constant. So this is the relationship between the standard Gibbs free energy change and equilibrium constant, but this relation is at equilibrium. That's the reason they have relation of this. And if would have been not at equilibrium, then the relationship would be delta G is equals to delta G naught plus 2.303 RT into the log to the base 10 of the quotient that we have, that is reaction quotient, or when they are represented in concentration, or the reaction quotient when they are represented in partial pressure. So this is what the relationship between the standard Gibbs free energy and equilibrium constant is. Very much simple to derive this thing. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you'll share this video with your friends. And yes, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.